minutes old. This will be 11 down and 4 to go. Corsetti's still trying to make it forward so he can get on the podium, while John Lebow is the master in the middle of the racetrack. Mayfield still sitting in the fifth place position. Corsetti once again coming off turn number 4. Mayfield followed by Souza, Dameron, Jesse Sanchez. This will be 13 and 2, downtown Ronnie Brown. It all night long that as good as Lonnie Pauley is, Ronnie Brown was really picking up the pace the last couple of weeks. The win at San Jose, I think, was the thing that set it on the fast one-third mile. And here on the lightning quick quarter mile, here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Ronnie Brown, victory lap. Second place, Paul Iwanaga. Great job for Paul. Third place to John Lebow III. He of the long, lean nature. Fourth and a good job going to Mark Corsetti over Steve Mayfield. Yeah. Ronnie Brown, sponsored by Rod Lake Racing, Pick Racing, Brown Cycles, and Top Dead Center, the Paso Robles 30-year-old rider, who is going to have some fun tonight. We get to the partying mode of life in motorcycle racing. Yes, Ronnie, just move anywhere you want. You can take that first place position even if you're on the left side. Gene Romero, the promoter of the West Coast Flat Track Series, presenting him with the trophies. Hi, Mike. I'm being told to wave it, Mike. Let's see if we can't get his helmet off so we can do this properly, folks. We appreciate everybody coming out. We know it was a good crowd and a lot of racing stuff that was going on here. And we think you guys had a fun time. Here's John Lebow III for third place. Paul Iwanaga gets the second place from Gene Romero. And the helmet comes off, but get it up now for downtown Ronnie Brown! He went downtown tonight in Watsonville. Yeah! Photo opportunity. And we'll all get over pit side and join in the frivolity of life. $1,000. Yeah, you could have been somebody. Yeah. For $1,000. It's more than that, actually. The point fund, I think, was $1,000. Oh, out of the second row, and a lot of elbow going in there. But it's Ronnie Brown on the top of the racetrack. Guys, lots of laps. Brown followed by Paul Iwanaga from the inside of the racetrack, the long, tall guy, John Lebow. Lebow followed by Rob Dameron, the black plate number 1. Mayfield doing some hammering now on Rob Dameron for that fourth place position. Corsetti goes up the inside and gives Dameron a bump and moves him right out of the way. And Corsetti goes from 7th to 5th, 6th to 4th, 8th to 3, 9 to 5. Mark Corsetti, with a move up on the inside, bounced off of Dameron and pulled off the pass of not only Dameron, but Stevie Mayfield. Corsetti on the move. Ronnie Brown now being picked up a little bit by Paul Iwanaga. Still Evo in third over Corsetti and Mayfield. Dameron followed by Souza. Eight down, seven to go. At the halfway point, Ronnie Brown looking like a champion. Corsetti that continues to come forward, still in fourth place, but hammering now on the backside of John Lebo the third. Still money up for grabs in all positions. Brown on a cruise control. This will be 11 down and 4 to go. Corsetti still trying to make it forward so he can get on the podium, while John Lebo is the master in the middle of the racetrack. Mayfield still sitting in the fifth place position. Corsetti once again coming off turn number 4. Mayfield followed by Souza, Dameron, and Jesse Sanchez. This will be 13 and 2, downtown Ronnie Brown. It all night long that as good as Lonnie Pauley is, Ronnie Brown was really picking up the pace the last couple of weeks. The win at San Jose, I think, was the thing that set it on the fast one-third mile. And here on the lightning quick quarter mile, here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Ronnie Brown.